Hey y'all, I'm gonna do a bonus video this week because Billie 4.3 is out. And if you have not updated your WordPress yet, you really need to take a moment, be sure you have a backup in place, right, before you click update. And then go ahead and click update. And let's get into some goodies that you're gonna have access to now with the new 4.3. Did y'all know that every major release that WordPress puts out, publishes, is named after a famous jazz singer? So this one, of course, named after Billie Holiday. So I'll put the link to this awesome review about the whole new version of WordPress. This kind of gives you a breakdown even further, but I'm gonna walk you through a couple of my favorite brand new things that they've done. I also want to make mention that this whole development project was led by Konstantin Obinlan, who you guys know if you were here at San Antonio WordCamp this past January. He was one of our speakers that traveled to hang out here with us for that day, and he was fantastic. Super tall guy, super smart guy. And you're going to see some of his efforts and his team's efforts right here today. So I'm going to post. This could happen in a post or a page. If you're doing some editing and you're wanting to type out some things and maybe do a header two inside of your website, sometimes you would have to do this. This would be a header two. Typically, we would have to stop for a second, highlight it, go up here, choose a header two, right? So that the nerd code would be written by WordPress. Well, now they've made it much easier for us to kind of skip down through things and say this would be our header two. And we enter down, look at that, you guys. So what I did was I used two hashtags to tell it to be a header two. Let's do three for right now, three. This would be three, enter down. And that would give us our header three. I'm gonna switch over to the nerd code mode so that you can see that it's header two, header three. It automatically knew what we were doing by using those hashtags now inside of 4.3. How groovy cool is that? And it will actually let you do that from 2 to 6 on your header tags. It won't let us do a header one with one single hashtag, and that's because typically an author will allow the title of your post to be in place of your header one. Does that make sense? All right, what else is cool for us in formatting our page really quickly and easily? Now, if we were to start typing a list, we no longer have to go up and click that little icon up here. Now we can just simply type a one and click enter, and it's going to allow us to have our list to here, here, here. How cool is this, you guys? And then what if we wanted to have a bullet list? We can actually use the asterisk and say this is a bullet list. What craziness, right? So exciting. And they gave us one other fun one. If we were to do an angle bracket, again, all of this has to take place in the visual mode, right? We can't do this in the text mode. This will be in the visual mode. If we were to do an angle bracket, this is a block quote. And enter down. Now right here, it doesn't look like it changed much except for it did indent. But once, let me move out of the way, once we go preview it on the front side of our website, depending upon what your author does for your block quotes, it could sit out like this. This is a block quote. See the little line that's here, a little bit of a larger font. Some of our authors in your themes will give it even a different background color and really make this block quote stand out and be beautiful down your page. How fun is this, you guys? Awesome, awesome moving forward with great formatting for our experience in the visual mode. So some other things that they did inside this update is they allowed us to have if we go into the customize area, they allowed us to do a favicon or fav icon. So up at the very top of your browser, let me move this down for a second so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. See right up here, whenever you have a page title, you want to have this little icon next to it so that if somebody were to bookmark your website, either on their desktop here or even on their cell phone, this little fav icon actually pops into their screen and becomes part of the bookmark, right? So the way you do that now is site identity, and then right here you can select your file, you can go into your media library, click select. It's going to help you kind of resize things. It's going to show you what it would look like on a cell phone, it's going to show you what it would look like on a desktop or a laptop, and we're going to go ahead and say crop our image down, and we're done. And now it's going to be appearing up here. How nice is that, you guys? Normally, that would have taken a plugin to do that, Or if you knew how to write some nerd code, you could have gone into your header file and gone ahead and addressed it that way. But this just makes it so much more easy. And this is another instance where WordPress is thinking more and more about mobile users, because really, truly, this is what you want to see. You want to have the ability to have a little icon appear on their cell phone, you know, basically like you would on any cell phone whenever you have, something sitting there here, if you can see it, you know, your little icon that sits there. How do you actually get that? This is where that pulls from. So nice for them to include that in there. I love it. And then some other things they did was really, really intelligent as well for our password security. So now when we go to add a new user, WordPress is automatically going to generate a password for us. We no longer have to toy with trying to create some really strenuous, long, crazy, strong password. And we certainly don't have to worry about our clients or our any of our users using our website generating some generic sort of password that would allow some sort of wormhole for hacking, right? So really, really thinking ahead for stronger security. That's something that they implemented here. And look how long that is. Isn't that crazy? So if you can't remember that, and you probably wouldn't be able to, you still have the ability to come in and change your own password. However, it's really going to hold you to trying to create something that was very, very difficult for hackers to be able to get into. Makes sense, doesn't it? And so super exciting. All right. Again, I'm going to put the link to this whole awesome tutorial here of everything, because I've just kind of touched on some of the things they've done for you. You're going to walk through some of the other really cool upgrades basically that they've given us, the ability to do some extra things inside the customizer. So check out that link in the description box below. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, because every single Wednesday I'm producing a video just like this to help us grow in our experience with WordPress. Have a great one. See you next time. Bye-bye.